In India, the Ayurveda is declining, declining and declining. Because the Shishyas are in search of money. Not the profit. So in a, many gurus may be there, I'm true. I'm not ridiculing everything. That is true. I cannot, because many people are there in and around. That is true, another thing. But the disciples are in search of money. Yes, I am Dr. Krishna Kumar, graduated from Coimbatore Ayurveda College. The study was in the Gurukula system for 7.5 years for the graduation. The course started at the course started in 1978, and I was one of the member of the first batch student from that college. And after 7.5 years of course, I went to post-graduation. And it took about 3 years. Usually in the Kerala, in India, the post-graduation for the Ayurveda is Doctor of Medicine. That is for 3 years. And I completed my post-graduation in 1990. And started my own Ayurvedic hospital and a manufacturing unit. And by the manufacturing unit I created, or I made, because all the medicines I used to make my own. Not the factory made medicines I am using for the patient. I am using my own medicine. More than 300 varieties of medicine I am preparing and giving to my patient. So after that I went to, in 91 I initiated with a Tantra Shastra. Actually, directly I don't want to do anything in Tantra Shastra, but I want to have the deep sense of Ayurveda. Probing the deep sense of Ayurveda, I reached the Tantric Guru, and it is Dr. Vijayan, or Parapattaraga Anangananda Pada Tirtha of Vadagara, Calicut District, Kerala. And he gave me the initiation, the supreme initiation in the Sri Vidya Sampradaya, and I presented more than 30 papers in international and national conference, and now working as an associate professor in an Ayurveda college in Kannur. At the same time I am doing my own practice of Ayurveda. Mm-hmm. Ayurveda is not Indian, or it is universal.
Mm-hmm.
No European Ayurveda, no American Ayurveda,
yeah.
No British Ayurveda, nothing. It is universal. Ayurveda is universal. If you want, first you get the vision of Ayurveda. To get the vision, first you go through the lines of Ayurveda, classics. Just lines. Then, if you want to have the true mission, you should go beyond the lines or in between the lines.
Mm-hmm.
Just don't utter that all the verses and verses and verses of the same classics and repeat it. Don't repeat it. You can repeat. In the lower stage you can repeat, because the sun at the lower standard used to tell that the sun is rising at, in the east. And you don't repeat the same thing after PhD. The sun is nor rising nor setting in the east or in the west. Is it not? So it is staying in one place and we are just rotating around. So after the PhD you don't talk nonsense. Clear? The nonsense means the same words you don't repeat.
Mm-hmm.
You go beyond the lines, between the lines. When you go beyond the lines and between the lines, you will get the true sense of true Ayurveda, then the mission is perfect. So first you create the vision. Now the vision and mission is mixed for everybody, because the vision is money, the mission is also money.
Mm-hmm.
So for them, every people, for every many people, the vision and mission is one and same. So that is not good at all.
Mm-hmm.
When you are developing the Ayurveda in the Brazil, means you are developing the Ayurveda universally.
Yeah.
When you are developing the Ayurveda in Kerala, means you are developing the Ayurveda universally. True?
Yeah.
So it is not marketing, exporting and importing of Ayurvedic medicine, I mean. You are, when you are dealing with the Ayurveda, you are dealing with the concept and philosophy of Ayurveda. Just you are using the water and just doing the dhara, shiro dhara with water, it is a Brazilian water, but the concept is Ayurvedic. So when you are doing this one, you cannot say that this is Brazilian water I am putting and I am curing the disease with Brazilian water. No, it is nonsense. You are putting with the concept and philosophy of the universal Ayurveda. That is a true Ayurveda. That should be, that vision should be there.
Mm-hmm.
So we need not export and import Ayurveda. If you are export and import the concept and philosophy of Ayurveda, that is perfect, that is the supreme thing. That only will stay in time. Otherwise, all the things will perish.
Mm-hmm.
If you are exporting and importing the Ayurvedic medicines, it will perish. No, no. If you are exporting the concept and philosophy, that won't perish.
Yeah.
That won't perish. It will stay. It is sustainable growth of Ayurveda.
Yes, in Brazil, everyone big florist, no?
Sir, certainly. Better than other parts of India. You just leave the Kerala, because Kerala, we have plenty of plants and medicines and trees.
Yeah.
The Brazilians, maybe, if they are knowing the concept and philosophy of the Dribya Guna of that plant,
mm-hmm.
certainly you can develop that.
Olá, tudo bem? Então, vocês acabaram de assistir essa super entrevista com o Dr. T.S. Krishna Kumar. Esse cara é incrível, eu adoro ele, nos meus professores preferidos, sabe? A forma dele falar é difícil, não é fácil, porque ele é um grande filósofo, ele é um mestre tântrico, né? Ele é um acharya de tantra, de uma tradição chamada Shri Vidya, que são adoradores de Devi, e ele é um grande médico ayurvédico, realmente a mente dele tá fora da nossa, do nosso patamar, ele tá bem além. É um sonho trazer ele pro Brasil. Mas eu queria convidar vocês pro seguinte, vocês viram que esse foi um videozinho pequenininho de 5 minutinhos. Vocês querem ver essa entrevista completa e dezenas de outras? Aqui embaixo na descrição, se você está assistindo pelo YouTube ou pelo Facebook, tanto faz, aqui embaixo ou aqui em cima, se for no Facebook, vocês têm o canal, o link onde vocês vão se cadastrar para assistir toda a segunda temporada do curso de Introdução à Ayurveda. Isso mesmo, esse vídeo ele faz parte do curso de Introdução à Ayurveda grátis, a segunda temporada. Então, vocês estão perdendo tempo? Pra quê? Vai lá, clica aqui embaixo ou clica aqui em cima, inscreva-se no curso e tem um ótimo curso. Se gostaram desse vídeo, dá uma curtida, dá um joinha, inscreva-se no canal do YouTube, inscreva-se também, curte aqui a nossa página no Facebook. Um grande abraço para vocês, vejo vocês no próximo vídeo. Namastê!